At its core, this is a story of deep and systemic injustice, of people who were harmed and all the ways in which society failed them. Systems that had been built to protect did not work, not by accident, but by design. This is a different story than the stories that have been told because, yes, it is a story about Dahmer, but it's also a story about the victims. It is a story not just about the victims who were murdered, but about the community, about the chilling impact of not just what Jeffrey Dahmer was able to do in all the harm, but all the ways in which the police, which the larger leadership in Milwaukee, which the media and so many others in society were complicit. This was not a situation of a lone wolf, which is oftentimes the story that gets told about Dahmer. And so what makes this different is that we get to understand and see the humanity of those who were murdered by Jeffrey Dahmer, but we get to understand and see it not as unfortunate, but as unjust. As the producer on this project and in my role as the leader of Color of Change, I wanted to make sure that we really enhance the deep understanding of the systemic racism in the Milwaukee Police Department, that we really enhance all the ways in which policing failed throughout each and every stage, the incentive structures that allowed a blonde-haired guy to continually kill and harm people, particularly black and brown people, and the ways in which homophobia also played a role, the ways in which police and those in power turned their backs instead of actually dealing with the situation. I wanted to enforce the humanity of these victims and their families. I wanted to make sure that we, as viewers, got to truly sort of understand how a situation like this takes place, not just through Jeffrey Dahmer's eyes, but through the eyes of people who had their own hopes and aspirations and dreams. And I wanted those things to be connected. I also wanted people to get a sense from activism, right? To see sort of the ways in which community leaders, whether they be the Ronald Flowers character or be Jesse Jackson, to see the engagement in activism. And of course, I also wanted people to see Glenda Cleveland as a real person and also as a larger representative of the ways in which we don't treat people who should be the protagonists in our stories as the protagonists, and as a result, we make the wrong decisions about who to listen to. But I have to say that the Ronald Flowers character, not just sort of the position that he was put in inside of Dahmer's grandmother's house, but his fight to get out and his survival, and then moving to be an activist, to work to help other young men in the community make sense of the situations and the challenges they were going through. I think that the arc of his character is important for viewers to see that people were responding and engaging and dealing with the harm and the trauma in a range of different ways, and the sort of fight of gay black men to be heard and to be seen and to dictate on their own terms a better world. I thought that that was really important. And it's a character that whose scenes were both challenging, but whose scenes were also deeply important for us to not just see the victimization, but the aspiration.